patterns. They are all around us. You can see patterns in buildings, patterns are used in clothing and design, and patterns are everywhere in math. Just look at the numbers on this ruler, the lines on this ruler, the lines on the paper. You might be wondering, what do patterns do? Well, patterns do the same things over and over again. Patterns repeat. Now this is super cool. Every pattern follows a special rule. The rule is how the pattern works. We'll give you an example. Look at this pattern. It begins with a red rectangle followed by a yellow rectangle. Next is a red rectangle and another yellow rectangle. Next is a red rectangle followed by another yellow rectangle. It's doing the same thing over and over again, so it is definitely a pattern. What special rule does this pattern follow? Well, rectangles alternate between red and yellow. Do you see that? The rule tells us how the pattern works. In this pattern, rectangles alternate between red and yellow. So remember, every pattern follows a special rule. The rule is how the pattern works. If you figure out the rule, you've cracked the pattern's code. Even if there is a part of the pattern missing, you will be able to find it because you cracked the code. Here is the pattern we just showed you. Imagine this spot missing. What belongs in this spot? Well, let's think of this pattern's rule. Rectangles alternate between red and yellow. So what color rectangle goes here? Yeah, a red rectangle. By figuring out the rule, we were able to fill this spot in the pattern. All right, we have another pattern here. Instead of shapes, we have numbers in this pattern. The first thing we need to do is find out what makes this a pattern. Look at each of the numbers and see if you can see a pattern. What rule does this pattern follow? Do you know? Yeah, you always add 1 to get the next number. Every number goes up by 1 each time. That's the pattern. Great job.
Okay, now we are going to play a game called Complete the Pattern. We'll show you a pattern, and then you can try to crack the code and complete it. Here's the first one. You'll notice there are a lot of shapes here, so we should probably just look at this pattern line by line and see what we discover. On this first line, we see a green circle, a blue square, and a green circle. It's almost like a blue square sandwich. The second line is similar to the first, except there are 2 squares in between the green circles instead of just 1. This third line is just like the second line, except there are 3 blue squares in between the green circles instead of 2. Notice a pattern? So let's complete this pattern. How many blue squares are in this fourth line? Yeah, 4. The fourth line has 4 blue squares in between the green circles. How can we know that? Well, the blue squares increase by 1 each line. The blue squares in between the green circles keep growing by 1 every line. That's how this pattern works. Great job. All right, Andy, really? He does this every afternoon. It's a pattern for him. Every afternoon he dances near the woods. We are playing Complete the Pattern, Andy. We don't have time for these super cool dance moves. They are pretty cool. Okay, they are. Oh, goodness. Kevin, I know you dance every afternoon as well. That's a pattern for you, too. But, Kevin, we really do have to get back to our game, okay? Come on. All right, if there are no more interruptions, all right, let's look at this next pattern. Oh, goodness, look at this series of creatures, these animals. The first is an interesting looking hamster, followed by 2 birds. Then there's a hamster, and then there's a mystery spot that we have to complete, and a bird. and then the hamster, and then two birds.
That's pretty cool. Let's complete this pattern. Just by looking at this pattern, what do you think goes in this spot? Yeah, a bird. A bird goes here. Now, how do we know that a bird goes here? Well, to crack the code and figure out the pattern, we have to look at the clues. We see a hamster first, followed by two birds. Then another hamster and two birds, and it goes on and on. The rule for this pattern, then, is that a hamster is followed by two birds, and then the pattern repeats. Patterns repeat. Andy, please! Okay, the kids are learning, please! Alright, patterns repeat. I was kind of waiting for Kevin. Okay, I guess he isn't going to interrupt. I'm kind of impressed. Oh, never mind. Never mind. Apparently I spoke too soon. Alright, Kevin, we really do have a final pattern to look at, okay? I think we're ready. Here is the final pattern for us to complete. Is this a pattern with shapes or numbers? Yeah, numbers. We need to figure out what the final number is in this pattern. Look at the different numbers and see what pattern you notice. Once you figure out what rule these numbers are following, you'll be able to figure out this last number. What is this missing number in the pattern? Yep, 4. Great job. How do we know that this missing number is the number 4? Well, what rule did you notice the pattern was following? Yes, subtract 1 to get the next number. So the first number is 9, and the next number is 1 less than 9, 8. Then you subtract 1 to get 7. You subtract 1 to get 6. You subtract 1 to get 5, and finally you subtract 1 from 5 to get our answer, 4. Okay, it's official. You are awesome at patterns. It's true. It's true. Patterns are so much fun. When you see a pattern, you can try to figure out what rule it is following. Patterns are all around us, just waiting to be discovered. Special thanks to our patrons who make videos like this possible. If you would like to support us and get cool Homeschool Pop tattoos, click the link below this video or visit homeschoolpop.com. As always, you are awesome. We hope to see you next video. Okay, what's going on with all this dancing? This guy's dancing too. He's spinning around at the beach in a suit. He's gonna get dizzy. What's with this? This is not going to be a pattern for future videos.